I remember Amy performing on the stage. The
place was packed.
What am I scared of? Myself.
I will always remember our last words. She said, I love you, Mummy.
The film is called Reclaiming Amy.
Yeah.
Who or what are you reclaiming her from?
I wondered that as well.
Oh, yeah, we wondered that as well.
Just this bile that's been piled onto that family.
I still get it now. You killed your daughter.
What we're trying to achieve is a more rounded image of Amy.
Oh, there she is. Hello, darling.
It was during this period that Mitchell became the public face of the family.
Now, I look back and there's lots of things I wish I'd have done differently.
And you mentioned, of course, the dark times, and yeah. The film doesn't shy away from those. Mitch, at one point you say mistakes were made when Amy was ill.
Mistakes were...
I think we didn't know what it was all about. We didn't know what to do.
Yeah, it's more, you know, as a family, we could stand on our heads. You know, how many times we had family interventions, I lost count. How many times I took her into rehabs and she'd walk out the next day. It's very difficult. So I don't think mistakes are the wrong, because there is no right or wrong way to deal with it. And the only people that would understand that are people who, within their family, are struggling with addiction.
It's only looking back now that I realise how little we understood.
The press coverage when Amy was ill was wall to wall. Do you think there has been any progress in the way the media treats celebrities in crisis in the 10 years since she's died?
Called her wino, they called her junkie, they called her drug addict. You know, that was the norm sort of 10, 15, 12 years ago, whenever it was. I'm not sure that they could get away with that today. And I think there's more of an understanding about mental health issues, which there wasn't then.
She wanted to be a mum. That's a bit of work up, so.
There's also Catriona, her friend, who reveals for the first time that they had a romantic relationship.
I can't really comment, because obviously I didn't know anything about Amy's sex life, and I don't particularly want to know about it. Well, Catriona and Amy were, they were sisters. They were more than best friends, as with Naomi and Chantel. And yet when Amy passed away, they helped prepare Amy for her final journey, so to speak. And these were girls in their early 20s. I mean, what a job to do, just to demonstrate how much they loved Amy.
In 10 years' time, I'd like to have a couple of kids.
On the 23rd, we're all together at the cemetery and have lunch together. And what will happen? The first 10 minutes, we'll be sobbing. And then after that, we'll be in fits of laughter with a new Amy anecdote.
But that's the main thing, that although it's not a joyful thing that you would go and celebrate it, but we do. We actually go and remember her. My joke is, now I know where she is.
That's a black joke.
Yes, but true.